好，弟兄姊妹平安。
Dear brothers, it's a peace be with you.
未来几周我们每个主日的讲到的经文呢都会比较长。
In the next coming few weeks, the length of our scripture are very long.
我们没有足够的时间在敬拜期间读所有的经文了。
Therefore, we might not have time to read all the scriptures during the sermon.
所以请大家在来教会之前或者在敬拜之前可以把我们要讲到的经文提前先读一下。
So before you come to worship on Sunday, please read the scriptures in advance.
我会提前把要讲到的经文通知大家。
We will inform the scripture in advance for you guys to prepare.
接下来的这个主日呢我们会讲启示录的第八章和第九章讲两章。
So in the next coming Sunday, we will go over Revelation chapter 8 and 9.
今天呢我们会讲第七章。
And today we are reading chapter 7.
开始之前我们一起先来祷告。
Before we start, let's pray.
天父我们再次要来到你的面前。
Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you.
我们祈求你的圣灵光照我们的心。
We pray that your Holy Spirit will do the work among us.
让我们看见天上的异象。
Help us see the vision in heaven.
让我们从心里面得到安慰。
And help us be comfort in our heart.
让我们得到盼望。
And let us give in hope.
让我们的信心得坚固。
And our faith will be steady.
用你的话语祝福你的教会。
And use your words to bless your church.
奉主耶稣基督的名。
My prayer in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
我们大家觉得新冠疫情有所缓解了。
How do we feel about the pandemics and it has been eased?
但是我们突然间听说印度的疫情又突然间严重了。
And we suddenly notice the pandemic in India has severe again.
是不是下一轮的疫情马上会开始呢？
Is the next round of pandemic will start?
我们不知道未来事态如何发展。
We don't know the future.
但是我们可以肯定一件事。
But one thing is certain.
就是这个世界上一定会有很多灾难。
And the tribulation in this world will be abundant.
即使新冠疫情结束了，还会有其他的灾难发生。
Even the pandemic pass is done, there will be more tribulation coming.
在几年前呢，北京的西安教会就被强制性的关闭了。
Few years ago, the church in Zion Church in Beijing was forced to close.
那前两天呢，西安教会的一个弟兄和一个姊妹又被逮捕了。
A few days ago, our brother in Zion Church was persecuted.
上个主日我们读了启示录第六章。
Last Sunday we read the Revelation chapter 6.
从第六章里我们看见会有很多的灾难发生。
In chapter 6 we saw a lot of tribulations.
包括战争。
Include wars.
饥荒。
Famine.
死亡。
Death.
逼迫。
Persecution.
等等。
Etc.
这些事情迟早会来的。
This thing will come.
我们要思考的问题不是如何逃避这些灾难。
We need to think about not to avoid it.
而是应该思考如何面对这些灾难。
But how to face these tribulations.
启示录第六章啊，描述的灾难还只是七印当中的前六印。
In chapter 6 Revelation, there's only 6 seals of the 7 seals.
第七印还没有打开。
The seventh seal has not opened yet.
如果前六印所代表的灾难都这么的可怕，那么第七印打开的时候，灾难不是更严重吗？
And we can see how severe the sixth seal was, and let's think about how severe will be for the seven seals.
每一个印呢，代表的那个灾难，就好像是一个勇猛的一个拳击手，一个灾难就像是那个拳击手狠狠的。
So every seal is like a consecutive punch from the brutal boxer, each by each.
他就像一连打了六拳。
And he hits us 6 in a row.
对手是招架不住的。
And we cannot take it.
这个对手被连打了六拳。
And the opponent was taking hit 6 times.
他会跪地求饶。
He will knee down and beg for,
住手住手。
Please stop.
实在招架不住。
I can't hold it anymore.
当我在读启示录第六章。
When I was reading chapter 6 of Revelation,
这六波的灾难一个接一个的来。
Six wave of seals was coming one after another.
就好像一个拳击手来着一连打了六拳。
It's like a six consecutive punch from the boxer.
读完了第六章的灾难。
After reading the six seals.
我也想向主说主话，暂停，暂停。
And I want to say to the Lord, please stop.
缓一缓。
Give me a break.
先不要揭开第七。
Let's not open the seventh seal.
给我一个喘息的机会。
Give me a chance to breathe.
实在是承受不住。
I can't hold it anymore.
如果末日的灾难这么可怕，我们该怎么面对？
If the tribulation at the end of the day has such effect,
主也体恤我们的软弱。
Lord knows our weakness.
到了第七章。
In chapter 7,
主没有马上揭开第七。
Lord did not reveal the seven seals.
而是先显现了一个在天上敬拜的意象。
But instead, he revealed a vision of worship in heaven.
如果我们要想有勇气面对地上的灾难的话，
If we find the courage to face a tribulation on earth,
我们就需要在第七章里面盼望天上的荣耀。
And we need to find a hope in heaven.
如果我们要想在地上的灾难中得到安慰的话，
If we want to find comfort during the tribulation on earth,
我们就需要相信神在天上给我们存留的应许。
We need to hold on to the promise that God is giving to us in heaven.
而启示录第七章就让我们可以得着这种安慰和勇气。
In Revelation chapter 7, we can find the hope and comfort.
那么在第七章我们可以看到的第一个真理。
And the first truth we see in chapter 7.
这个真理就是神在灾难中会保守他儿女的救恩。
The truth is, God will ensure the salvation of his children in the tribulation.
第七章的第一节这样说。
In the first verse of chapter 7.
说到有四位天使掌管地上四方的风。
It says that the angels were in charge of the winds from all directions.
他们可以用风毁灭陆地、海洋和树木。
And they can destroy the land, the sea, and the tree with the wind.
但是还有另外一位天使。
But there's one more angel.
这位天使不让他们用风毁坏海洋、陆地和树木。
This angel prevented the other angels to harm the land, sea, and trees.
这位发命令的天使拿着神的印。
This commander angel has a seal from God.
这代表了这位天使是神亲自授权来执行神的旨意的。
It means that this angel was authorized by God and holds his will.
他的命令是出于神。
And the will was coming from God.
因为天使是神的差役。
And we know angels are the servant of God.
而神掌控所有的环境。
And God's in charge of the environment.
神是创造天地的主。
God is the Lord who created heaven and earth.
神也是护理整个宇宙的主。
And he has, he's also taking care of his creation.
风雨雷电全都掌控在神的手中。
Wind, thunder, and lightning are all under his control.
在旧约时代，以利亚曾经好几年不向神祷告，神就几年不降雨在地上。
In the Old Testament, Elijah did not pray to God, and there was no rain in a few years.
后来以利亚在加密山上向神祈求，神就降下暴雨。
And when Elijah was praying in Mount Carmel, the Lord rained heavily on earth.
神是借着以利亚向以色列人宣告，耶和华是那位掌管天地的主。
So God used Elijah to declare to the Israelites that Yahweh is the Lord in charge of heaven and earth.
主耶稣在地上的时候，他已平定风浪。
And when Lord Jesus was on earth, he calmed the storm.
显明他是那位掌管宇宙、掌管自然、掌管环境的主。
And it proves that he is the Lord of the our environment.
神对大自然的护理之功是如此的全面，如此的细微。
So God's providence for the nature is so comprehensive and so detailed.
神不会漏掉任何一个细节。
He will not miss a thing.
神也掌管风。
He's in control. He's in charge of wind.
风是什么？
So what is wind?
风是空气流动产生的现象，对吗？
So we can say wind is a phenomenon by flowing of air.
神掌管风。
God's in control of wind.
神控制着风，空气当中每一个氧气分子和氮气分子移动的速度和方向。
So God's in control of every oxygen and nitrogen in the air, and he controls themMoving position in every dust and wind.
每一粒尘埃， 空气中的每一粒尘埃都在神的掌控之中。
Every dust is in control by God.
神让风停，风就会停。
If God wants wind to stop, it stops.
神让风吹起，风就会吹起。
If God wants wind to blow, it blows.
想象一下。
Imagine this.
展开你的想象力。
Use your imagination.
在空气中有一粒新型冠状病毒。
Imagine there is a one virus, coronavirus in the air.
这一粒病毒在空气中漂浮。
And this virus is floating on the air.
有一阵风吹着这一粒新冠病毒朝着我飘了过来。
So a gust of wind blowing the virus toward me.
当然我是不知道的，因为我看不见。
I do not know it's coming.
但是上帝知道。
But God knows.
他用奇妙的护理之功，让空气流动的方向突然间发生了改变。
And He used His wonderful work of protecting to suddenly change the direction of the wind.
于是这一粒新冠病毒和我擦肩而过。
Therefore, this coronavirus passed right by me.
就这样，神掌控环境。
And God is in control of the environment.
神就保守我到今天还没有感染新冠病毒。
So God has protected me and has prevented me from the virus.
弟兄姊妹，在你不知道的情况下，神已经保守你脱离了很多次灾难。
Dear brothers and sisters, before you know it, God has protected you from many disasters.
神是环境的主人。
God's in control of the environment.
当大灾难来临的时候，我们每一个人都没有办法逃脱这个苦难的大环境。
When the tribulation comes, there's no way we can escape from it.
我们都活在这个灾难的大环境里。
We all live under this tribulation.
但是我们更是活在神的手。
But we are living in God's hand as well.
因为灾难也在神的手。
Because tribulation is also in the hands of God.
你和我更在神的手。
And you and me are both in the hands of God.
在启示录第七章。
In Revelation chapter 7.
神为什么暂时不让风毁坏陆地、海洋和树木呢？
So why didn't God stop the wind to destroy the land, the sea, and trees?
因为神要让天使去印神众仆人的额头。
Because God asked angel to put seals on the forehead of his servant.
神要让他的众仆人额头上留下印记。
And God wants his servant to have a seal on his forehead.
在这些人额头上留下神的印记之前，神不让风毁坏世界。
Before God sealed the forehead of his servant, God do not want the wind to destroy the land.
神掌控环境很显然有一个目的。
God in control of the environment has its purpose.
这个目的就是要成就他的旨意。
This purpose is to fulfill his will.
而这个旨意是什么呢？
And what is this will?
很显然这个旨意是神要保守他要拯救的人可以得救。
And this will is God will ensure the salvation of the people that he planned to save.
留下额头上留下神的印记。
And there is a seal on his forehead.
这就意味着这个人是属神的。
It means this man is belong to God.
他是神的儿女。
He's a children of God.
他是一个被神拯救的。
He's saved by God.
额头上留下印记的人有144,000人。
And the people who have seal on their forehead is 144,000.
这里还提到了以色列支派的一些名字。
And we can see the tribes in here that mention in scripture.
每一个支派12,000人。
Every tribe has 12,000 people.
十二个支派一共144,000人。
Therefore, 12 tribes equals 144,000.
这一段经文的解释非常的不容易很有争议。
And this scripture is very controversial.
有人认为这144,000人是代表普世教会的所有成员。
Some people think that these 144,000 people represent all the members of the universal church.
所以这种观点认为这里面的144,000不是字面意义上准确的144,000，而是很多很多人。
So the interpretation is that there actually are more people than 144. It's not in the literal sense.
包括全世界各个民族所有的基督徒。
It includes all the Christians around the world.
还有一种观点认为说，这里面的144,000人是代表在主耶稣再来之前末日灾难期间，神要特别保守的一些以色列人。
So some people think that these 144,000 are representative of the Israelites that God wants to keep during the tribulation at the end of days.
这144,000人是不是外邦的基督徒。
And that they are not included in the Gentile Christians.
他们是犹太族当中在末日灾难期间特别啊被神保守信主得救的啊一些犹太人的基督徒。
And they are the descendants of Israel, and they are not Gentile Christians.
因为在后面第九节又谈到了各族、各国、各方、各民的人，那些人很显然是外邦的基督徒。
And because in verse 9, it talks about people from all nations, tribe, people, and language.
那些人很显然是外邦的基督徒。为什么？因为教会是有犹太的基督徒，当然也有外邦的基督徒，共同组成教会。
It's clear that these people are the Gentile Christians.And Jewish Christians and Gentile Christians, they come together and they form the church.
那么在主耶稣基督再来之前，末日的灾难的期间，神也特别保守以色列人，一些以色列人啊，成为属神的儿女，保守他们的救恩。
So before Jesus' second coming, God has also saved the children of God among the Jews during the tribulation at the end of the days.
而且呢，这里面还罗列了雅各的十二个后裔的名字。
In addition, the name of the descendants of Jacob are listed in here.
那很显然，这里指的是以色列人。
And it's obvious it's referring to Israel.
啊，尽管以色列人呢、啊，在公元前722年之后，很多人他们属于哪一个支派的这个身份定位，慢慢的他们已经啊分不清楚，这个身份定位慢慢的模糊了。
Also before Many Israelites lost their tribal status after 722 BC, but God knows every single one of them.
啊，但是就像刚才学士说的，神知道他们的身份。
And it means
所以神有这个能力要保守他们的救恩。
And because God knows them, that's why our God knows how to save them.
啊，但是有一种解释肯定是错的。
But there's one explanation that's definitely wrong.
有一个异端，我们都知道耶和华见证人。
And we know there is a Jehovah's Witness.
他们对这段的解释是说，他们认为说只有这十四万四千人可以和主耶稣同在天堂。
So the explanation of Jehovah's Witness is definitely unacceptable because they say that only 144,000 people will be saved.
这很显然是违背圣经的。
It's clear that it's against the Bible.
那这段经文里还有几个很奥秘的。
There are several mysteries in this passage.
为什么这里面的支派没有提到但支派呢
？So why there's no tribe of Dan among these tribes？
为什么提到了约瑟，又提到了约瑟的儿子马拿西，但是没有提到约瑟的另外一个儿子以法莲
？So why there is Joseph and Joseph's son Manasseh, but not his other son Ephraim？
这是一些很难解释的一些奥秘。
And these are difficult mysteries。
虽然不同的圣经学者可能提出一些的解释和猜想
，although different scholars, Bible scholars have to put with some explanation for this.
但是让我们专注于更明显的神的旨意。
Let's focus on the clear, correct, clear will of this passage.
那么更明显的神的旨意就是神会保守他儿女的救恩。
The clear message in here is God will ensure the salvation of His children.
即使发生了灾难
Although there is a tribulation,
神也会在灾难中保守他要拯救的人可以得救
And in tribulation, God will protect and ensure the salvation of his children.
这并不是说神会让他要拯救的人免去灾难
It doesn't mean that God will prevent the death of his children of God.
而是说神会保守他们免于永死的结局永恒的救恩神是保守的
It means that God will ensure their salvation for in eternal life.
即使神允许我们在灾难中，我们的肉体会死亡。
Although God allow our physical body to die in tribulation,
神也一定会保守我们在天堂里与他同在。
God ensure that we will be in heaven with him.
神会保守他儿女的救恩。
God will ensure their salvation.
四方的风还没有吹起来。
Winds in all directions has not blown yet.
陆地、海洋和树木还没有被毁灭。
Land, the sea and the tree has not destroyed.
为什么呢
？Why is that?
因为神还没有用他的印完他仆人的额头。
Because God has not done seal the forehead of his servant.
当神用他的印这些人的额头。
Once God has done seal their forehead.
这就意味着这些人是属神的。
It means that these people belongs to God.
灾难、魔鬼、 无法夺走他们永恒的生命。
Satan's in hell, and they could not take away these children from them.
因为他们是属神的。
Because they belong to God.
神让四风的风暂时没有吹起来。
God paused the wind from all directions to blow.
目的是要拯救属他的儿女。
The purpose of it is to save his children.
同样的原则应用在我们的身上。
The same idea applies to us.
我们今天为什么还活着？
Why are we still alive?
为什么神没有让新冠病毒夺走你和我的生命？
Why didn't God use the coronavirus to take our lives?
因为神要在我们的生命中来完成他的旨意。
Because God has will in our life to fulfill.
这个旨意和救恩有关系。
And this will is connecting to the salvation.
对于还没有重生得救人来说。
For those who has not been saved.
神没有让他们死于灾难当中。
God has not put them to death in the tribulation.
那是因为神还在给他们机会让他们悔改信耶稣。
It means God is still giving them the chance to be saved and repent.
对于已经重生得救的基督徒来说。
For those who already been saved and repent,
神没有让我们死于灾难。
God did not put us to death.
是因为神给我们机会，让我们去更多认识他。
It means God wants to us to know Him more.
神给我们更多的时间，让我们去爱他。
God gave us more time to love Him.
神给我们更多的年日，让我们能够去预备迎接天堂。
God gave us more days to be prepared for the heaven in coming.
这并不是说神永远不让我们在灾难中丧生。
It doesn't mean God we will live forever without death.
当神在我们人生当中的计划完成的那一天。
When we are fulfilled the salvation in our days.
神会叫我们离开世界。
God will take away from our life.
那一天他会接我们到他的乐园去。
In that day come, he will take us to his paradise.
所以未来有一天我有可能感染新冠病毒。
One day in the future, I might get a virus.
或者我感染其他的疾病。
And there might be other disease.
或者我也被逼迫。
And I might be persecuted.
或者我遭遇某一场的灾祸，我就死去了。
And there might be other disaster coming that will cause my death.
当那一天到来的时候，就意味着神在我人生中的计划完成了。
When that day comes, it means that the plans God has in my life has been fulfilled.
我就可以安然去世了。
And I can pass away peacefully.
但是那一天还没有来到。
But that day has not come yet.
那是因为神在我人生中的计划还没有完成。
It means that God's plan in my life has not been fulfilled.
这个计划和救恩有关系。
And this plan has something to do with salvation.
对我个人来讲，神让我有机会在救恩上继续的成长。
Personally, it means that I can grow in salvation more.
另外一方面，也让我有更多的机会去牧养弟兄姊妹，让你们也能够在救恩上我们一同成长。
It means that I can shepherd our brothers and sisters in church, and you guys will grow in salvation as well.
现在已经是2021年5月份了。
Now we are entering the May of 2021.
这一年一转眼都快过去一半了。
And we can see that half the year is almost passed.
你不觉得时间过得很快吗？
Don't we feel like time is flying by so quick?
但是世界上的灾难还没有停止。
But the tribulation in the world has not stopped yet.
可是时间又过得这么快。
But the time is flying by so quick.
前几天太太给我剪头发。
Few days ago, my wife cut my hair.I look down and see the hair.
抓起一把头发。
And I grab the hair.
哇，我吓了一跳。
I was scared.
哇，我的白头发这么多啊。
I noticed all the gray hair on my hand.
在那一刻，我明白一个道理。
At that moment,
我没有理由让自己活得更轻松一点。
There's no reason for me to live an easy life.
因为人生是有限的。
Because our days are limited.
日子在一天一天的减少。
And days are decreased each day.
总要趁着还有今天，竭力多做主工。
While we are still alive, we need to do God's work.
弟兄姊妹，神还让你仍然活着。
God still makes you are still alive.
神在你的人生里还有未完成的旨意。
It means that you still have plans to be fulfilled in your life.
所以不要懈怠。
So do not be hesitate.
珍惜机会。
Cherish the opportunity.
在救恩上追求成长。
And pursue the salvation and continue to grow in Him.
趁着四方的风还没有吹起来。
While the wind from all directions has not blown yet.
趁着陆地、海洋、树木还存留着。
While the land, the sea, and the tree are still here.
趁着我们还有一口气息。
While we are still alive.
预备我们自己迎接天上那个永恒。
prepare ourselves for the coming of heaven that we are going to.
启示录第七章给我们看到的第二个真理。
In Revelation chapter, we see the second truth.
神应许他拯救的人可以在天堂享受荣耀。
God promised that the people he saved will enjoy in eternal glory in heaven and receive comfort from him.
神应许他所拯救的人在天上可以得到从神而来的安慰。
God promised those people who saved will receive the comfort in him in heaven.
第九节到第十二节。
From verse 9 to 12.
约翰看见了天上敬拜的异象。
John saw a vision of worship in heaven.
那里有许多的人。
There's so many people.
不计其数。
Countless.
他们是从各国、各族、各民、各方而来的人。
They are from every nation, tribe, people, and language.
弟兄姊妹，你和我，我们在不在其中
？Dear brothers and sisters, are we in one of them?
我们在吗
？Are we in?
你在那里吗
？Are you there?
各族、各国、各民、各方的人呢
？People from all nation, tribe, language, and people.
有从亚洲来的人。
And there's people from Asia.
有从美国来的人。
And there's people from United States.
有从非洲来的人。
And there's people from Africa.
你和我，那是你和我，我们在其中组成的一个敬拜团队啊。
And we can call it a worship team formed by you and me.
我们穿着白衣。
We dress in white.
手拿棕树枝。
Holding the palm branches.
站在宝座和羔羊面前大声的喊叫。
Standing in front of a throne and the lamb and shouting.
愿救恩归于坐宝座上，我们的神也归于羔羊。
Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb.
这是一场热情澎湃的敬拜。
And it's a worship full of a passion.
这里的经文说是大声的喊叫。
The verse says here, we shouting out in the high voice.
大声的喊叫啊。
In the high voice.
要比我们星期天在这儿唱诗歌的声音要大多了。
It's a whole lot louder than the worship.
用我们所有的气力去喊叫，赞美神。
And we worshiping we in loud voice.
愿救恩归于坐宝座上，我们的神也归于羔羊。
Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb.
我们还有一班伴唱啊。
We still have a group of background singers.
那是一班天使。
They are the angels.
当我们发出赞美之后，天使做出了回应。
When we utter the praise, the angel respond.
他们说阿门。
They respond, Amen.
颂赞、荣耀、智慧、感谢、尊贵、权柄、大力，都归于我们的神，直到永永远远。
Praise and glory and wisdom and thanks and honor and power and strength be our Lord forever and ever.
最后他们说什么
？At last they say,
"Amen."
Amen.
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 这是一个敬拜的二重唱啊，弟兄姊妹，这是一个二重唱。
This is a duet of worship.
有两个敬拜的队伍。
There are two teams of worship.
一个队伍是我们这些人。
One team is people like us.
还有一个队伍是天使。
Another team is angels.
我们还手里拿着棕树枝。
And we are holding the palm branches.
人、天使、棕树枝。
People, angel, and palm branches.
所有的受造之物一起的来敬拜神。
And all the creations are coming and worship God.
这是一场和谐的敬拜。
This is worship of harmony.
丰富的敬拜。
It's a worship in abundance.
特别优美的敬拜。
And it's a worship of grace.
充满荣耀的敬拜。
And it's filled with glory.
神让我们沉浸在这样一个荣耀的敬拜当中。
God has given us to worship him in a situation like this.
这是神给我们的应许。
This is promise from God.
当我们穿越灾难之后，神让我们进入那个荣耀的天堂，在那里亲自的敬拜那位荣耀的神。
After going through the tribulation, we'll enter the glorious heaven and worship our God personally.
我想到诗篇六十六篇第十二节。
I'm thinking about Psalm chapter 66, verse 12.
经文说：“我们经过水火，你却使我们到丰富之地。”
It says, "We went through fire and water, but you brought us to a place of abundance."
神给我们预备的最美好的丰富之地，就是他与我们同在的天堂。
The best place God has prepared.For us is that He's in heaven with us.
人生的首要目的是什么
？What is the primary purpose of life?
人生的首要目的是荣耀神，并且以他为乐，直到永远。
The primary purpose of life is to glorify God and enjoy God forever.
如果说这里面的第九到第十二节是描述了那一幅荣耀神的那一幅画面。
If the verse 9 to 12 describe the picture of glorifying God,
那么接下来的13到17节就是描述了我们以神为乐的这样一个画面。
Then the verses in verse 13 to 17 describe our delight in God.
第15节说在神的宝座前我们昼夜侍奉他。
In verse 15 says that we worship him, we serve him in days and night. We
昼夜侍奉他。
We worship him day and night.
昼夜侍奉他。
Day and night.
哇，这样一个败坏的罪人居然可以侍奉那位圣洁伟大的神。
A corrupt sinner like me are able to serve him and worship him, a great and holy king.
这是何等的福分。
What a blessing it is.
我们可以侍奉他。
We are able to worship him.
他是那么的圣洁。
He is so holy.
我是这么的污秽。
And I'm so corrupted.
他是那么伟大。
He is so great.
我是这么渺小。
And I'm so little.
我是这么不配。
I'm so unworthy.
居然可以侍奉他。
But I'm able to worship him.
昼夜侍奉他。
And when I'm able to worship him day and night.
侍奉这个词让我们想到一种主人和仆人的关系。
When we think of serving, we think of a master and servant relationship.
神是主人。
God is a master.
我们是仆人。
And we are the servants.
他尊贵我们卑微。
He is noble and we are humble.
他配合我们的侍奉。
And he is worthy of our service.
但是这里还把神和我们的关系描述为父子一般的关系。
But in here, the relationship also described as a father and son.
第十五到十六节。
In verse 15 and 16.
说做宝座的要用帐幕覆庇他们。
It says that the one who sits on the throne will spread his tent over them.
他们不再饥，也不再渴。
They will never be hungry and they will never be thirst.
日头和炎热也不再伤害他们。
The sun will not be upon them, nor any scorch heat.
神要做我们的保护者。
God is to be our protector.
就好像我们在座的父母为你的孩子提供保护一样。
It's as if our parents protecting his own child.
当然，神的保护要比我们这些做父母的为孩子提供的保护更完美。
But God's protection is so much superior than the, our parents.
就安息在父神的保护之下。
And we will find peace under his protection.
除此以外，
In addition,
主耶稣还要亲自的牧养我们。
Our Lord Jesus will personally shepherd us.
对于像是一个牧人和他的群羊之间的那个关系。
And it's like a relationship between the shepherd and the flock.
主耶稣领我们到生命水的泉源。
Our Lord Jesus will lead us to the spring of living water.
让我们能够得饱足。
And we will be satisfied.
让我们灵力不再缺乏。
And we will feel no lack in our spirit.
被主耶稣供养。
Being shepherded by Lord Jesus.
和生命水的泉源。
And drink the springs of water.
我相信那一种满足感是用语言没有办法描述的。
I feel that sense of satisfaction that cannot be described in words.
我们想象一下我们在这个世界上所得到的那一些短暂的满足感。
Imagine the all the short term of satisfaction in this world.
这个世界上最有趣的游戏。
The most fun game in the world.
最浪漫的爱情。
The most romantic love.
最奢华的房子。
The most luxurious place.
最昂贵的汽车。
The most expensive car.
所有这些东西带给人的那种满足感加在一起的总和可能都比不上主耶稣给我们的牧养。带来的满足感的万分之一。
The sum of all these secular enjoyment cannot compare to the 1,000th of the satisfaction brought to us by our Lord Jesus.
在天上
In heaven,
我们可以以神为乐，直到永远。
We'll enjoy in God forever.
第十七节最后一句话。
In the last sentence of verse 17,
说神必擦去我们一切的眼泪。
It says God will wipe away every tear from our eyes.
代表了我们在世上所承受的痛苦、悲伤会被神抹去。
It means the pain and sorrow we endure in this world will be erased by God.
是用他的爱来安抚我们的心。
And he will comfort our heart with his love.
神用喜乐来取代我们的悲伤。
And replace our sorrows with joy.
神亲自地安慰我们。
He will comfort us personally.
让我们来思想一下创世纪。
Let us think about Genesis.
当神打发我们的始祖亚当夏娃离开伊甸园的时候。
When God drove Adam and Eve, our ancestors, out of the Garden of Eden,
神给他们做了一件皮子的衣服。
God made a garment of skin for them.
神还给他们穿上这件衣服。
And God clothed them.
那是神和人在伊甸园里最后的一次亲密接触。
And that was the last close contact between God and man of the Garden of Eden.
神给人穿上了一件皮子做的衣服。
When God guard them with garment skin,
然后人就离开伊甸园。
And the man
离开了神。
And man walk out of the Garden of Eden and left God.
将来在天上。
And one day in heaven,
我们穿着神用他的爱子耶稣的宝血洗净的衣服。
That God will wash for us with the blood of His beloved Son, Jesus Christ.
神和人要再一次的亲密接触。
God and the people will once again in close contact.
他要擦去我们一切的眼泪。
He will wipe away all our tears.
我相信在天堂，我们不需要再为世界上的痛苦而流眼泪了。
I believe in heaven that we will no longer in tear over the sufferings in this world.
如果我们在天堂会流眼泪的话，
if we are still able to shed tears in heaven,
我相信那一定是感恩的眼泪。
It will be the tears of the gratitude.
让我们来展开想象力，想象一下。
Let's use our imagination.
当我们真的在天上看见神，
when we see God in heaven,
看见他的身上还有钉子的痕迹的我们的主耶稣。
And we see the nail in his hand of the Lord Jesus Christ.
当我们亲眼地看见他，
when we see him in person,
我看见了为你和我的罪，为我的罪。
We see,
钉痕伤害的那个身体。
We see that our Lord Jesus who suffered for us and his nailing cross, nailing hand.
我想我们会流泪的。
And, I'm sorry.
我们会流泪的。
And we will be in tears.
感谢神你这么的爱我。
And we want to thank you, Lord, for loving us so much.
感谢主耶稣为我这个败坏的罪人牺牲在十字架上。
We want to thank him that he's now on the cross for our sin.
当泪水充满我们的眼眶的时候，
when the tears were spilled in our eyes,
神的手来抚摸我们的眼角，
God's hand will comfort our eye.
他抹去我们眼睛里的泪水，
and he will wipe away all our tears.
为神流的泪水必被神擦干。
The tears shed for God will be wiped away by God.
当我们想到天上这种极重无比的荣耀，
When we think about the incomparable glory of heaven,
我们想到从神而来的安慰，
And when we think about the comforts that are coming from God,
那么今天在世界上这一些所谓的灾难其实真的不足见，
And we will not mind the tribulation that we are experiencing in earth today.
今天在这个世界里所承受的痛苦其实也是至暂至轻。
And the pain we endure in this world, it feels light and momentary.
我想这是启示录第七章让我们得到的安慰。
And I believe the chapter 7 of Revelation, it comforts us.
灾难总是会发生的。
Tribulation will happen.
我们没有办法逃避灾难。
And there's no way to escape from it.
我们要学习的是如何面对灾难。
We need to learn is how to face it.
如何在灾难的环境里成就神美善的旨意。
And how we need to learn how to face it and how to use in how to accomplish God's will in it.
我们活在一个多灾多难的世界。
And we live in the world full of disaster and difficulties.
但是世界是在神的手里。
But the world is in hands of God.
灾难在神的手。
And the tribulation is also in hands of God.
你和我更在神的手。
You and me are also.They are both in hands of God.
神在灾难中可以保守我们的救恩。
God will ensure our salvation in tribulation.
神应许我们在天上得享从他而来的荣耀和安慰。
God also promises to enjoy glory and comfort in heaven forever.
神的这个应许必然会实现的。
The promise given by God will be fulfilled.
因为主耶稣已经在十字架上完成了赎罪的工作。
Because our Lord Jesus has completed the atonement work on the cross.
第十四节。
Verse 14 says,
第十四节说，这些人曾用羔羊的血把衣裳洗白净了。
In 14 it says, they have washed their robe and made them white in blood of the lamb.
是因为主耶稣已经在十字架上为我们流血。
It is because our Lord Jesus shed blood on the cross.
所以我们的罪可以得洁净。
So that our sin can be cleansed.
所以今天当我们预备我们的心来领用主餐时。
So today, when we are having the Lord's Supper today,
让我们再一次的纪念主耶稣。
Let us remember,
主耶稣在十字架上承受了最大的苦难。
Our Lord Jesus endured the greatest suffering on the cross.
他流的血是我们得救的保证。
And his bloodshed is guarantee of our salvation.
另外一方面，第十四节也谈到了我们这些蒙恩得救的人，我们在成圣的过程中当尽的本分。
Verse 14 also talks about the duty of the saved people in the sanctification.
第十四节，这一句话的主语是我们这些蒙恩得救的人。
The subject of the sentence is for us who have been saved by grace.
我们曾用羔羊的血把衣裳洗得白净。
And we have been washed away by the blood of our Lord.
主耶稣已经为我们流血了。
Our Lord has bled for us.
而我们的信心要扎根在主耶稣基督的宝血赎罪的功效里面。
And our faith and should be established on the atonement work by our Lord Jesus.
就好像把我们的衣服脱下来，把它浸泡在主耶稣基督的宝血里面。
It is as we take off our clothes and let it be a soak in our Lord Jesus' blood.
把我们的生命浸泡在耶稣基督的宝血里。
And let us soak in our Lord Jesus' blood.
洗得白净。
And we can be washed away clean.
就意思就是说，让我们去有责任去依靠主耶稣宝血洁净的功效，去追求一个圣洁的生活。
It means that we have the responsibility to rely on the blood of the Lord Jesus to pursue holiness.
就是活出一个与救恩相称的生活。
It is to live a life equivalent to the salvation.
所以当我们今天领用饼杯的时候，
And today when we see the bread and the cup,
就是来激励我们，
ask God to encourage us,
依靠主耶稣基督的恩典来过成圣的生活，
to live a holy life by relying on Lord's grace.
让我们一起祷告。
Let's pray.
天父，你是掌管天地的主。
Father, you are the Lord of heaven and earth.
我们在地上经历的一切都不是徒然。
Everything we experience is not in vain.
因为是你叫万事互相效力，叫爱你的人得益处。
Because you make all things work for the good of those who love you.
而那最终的益处就是我们可以得享你在天上给我们应许的荣耀。
The ultimate benefit is the glory you promised us in heaven.
为了成就你的应许，你差派你的爱子到世上。
In order to fulfill your promise, you send your beloved Son, Jesus Christ.
让主耶稣在十字架上为我们流血。
And into the world and bear the suffering for us.
好让我们被你拯救，我们可以在天上昼夜的侍奉。
So that we can be saved and serve you day and night in heaven.
是你的宝血洗净我们的罪。
It is your blood cleans us our sin.
我们感谢。
We want to thank you.
除了你的宝血以外，我们没有其他得救的途径。
Only through your precious blood we can be saved.
救恩归于坐在宝座上我们的神，也归于羔羊。
Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne, and it belongs to the Lamb.
奉主耶稣基督的名。
In the name of the Lord Jesus, we pray. Amen.
好，我们请弟兄姊妹，如果你也受洗过，然后你的心也预备好的话呢，我们就到前面来领用饼。
For brothers and sisters who have been baptized, if you have prepared your heart, please come to the front to receive the